Hey everyone, welcome back to our channel 1134 Press, where we share bookmaking, journaling, and papercraft inspiration every Sunday and Wednesday. So today I wanted to do a review of the We Are Memory Keepers bookbinding guide. It's something that I've seen on Amazon. I was always curious about to see if it's a tool that I should have in my bookmaking kit. So in today's tutorial, I am going to show you how I make a Japanese stab bound sketchbook. And then I will give you my honest opinion on what I think about it, if it's something that you should get or just skip past it. So first, let's get into what the actual kit comes with. The We Are Memory Keepers bookbinding guide is essentially a ruler. It comes with a guide that you can use to punch holes for whatever binding you want to sew. It also has a side for punching holes into signatures. It also comes with a little pouch that contains an awl, a straight and curved sewing needle, wax line thread, and a booklet with instructions on how to do Coptic and Japanese stab binding. To make this sketchbook, you'll need two pieces of thick leather, watercolor paper, thread, awl, and needle. I ended up going with the straight needle instead of the curved. Someone asked me in the comments section of one of my tutorials on how to make a junk journal from old books what size needles I use for my projects. The answer is that I never know what size needles I use for my projects. I keep all my needles in this box and choose needles based on the thickness of my thread and the size of the holes that I punched, along with other factors that I think will make binding the book the most comfortable for me. For this project, I opted to not use the needles that came with the bookbinding guide because the sketchbook I'm making is too thick. So instead, I chose a longer, thicker needle. Before I started punching holes into my paper, I referenced the booklet's instructions on how to do the Japanese stab binding stitch. They show you how to do 5 variations. I customized the hole spacing because my book pages are shorter than what's shown in the booklet. I went with the yellow stitch variation, but you'll see later that I had to deviate from that design based on a few factors. One being that I didn't make the holes in my book big enough to be able to re-enter into the holes more than twice. This is something to consider before you begin sewing. If I were to do this project again, I would make my holes bigger using a screw punch. If you're not sure what that tool is, I'll link a video in the cards and description below of when I've used this screw punch tool. But you shouldn't have this issue if you are using thinner paper and a thinner cover. For this book, you will use the top and middle rows of the guide to punch your holes. Punch into the second hole in the top row and then the hole diagonally below in the second row. Repeat this step at the end of the paper so your holes will mirror. Next, starting with the hole in your second row, count 7 spaces, then punch a new hole. From that new hole, count 5 spaces, then punch a new hole. You should have 4 evenly spaced holes in the second row. Repeat this step with all of your pages and covers. The first step to sewing your book is to enter into the second hole of your back cover, and then to do the same with your pages and then your front cover. Next, you'll enter into the hole closest to the one you exited. You'll repeat this step of weaving in and out until you get to the last hole in the second row. I was having issues pulling the needle in and out of the watercolor and the leather, so I opted to use a pair of pliers to make it easier to pull the needle out. This goes back to what I was saying earlier, that I should have made the holes a little bit bigger. Once you've pulled the thread through the last hole of the second row, you'll wrap the thread around the side of the book and then enter through that hole again. Then we'll enter into the hole above, making a diagonal stitch. Next, we'll wrap the thread around the side and enter into that same hole again. Then you'll enter into the hole below in the second row and weave the thread back and forth in the second row of holes to finish the length. When you get to the last hole, you'll repeat the same steps as before to create the decorative corner. Last is to tie and cut the loose strings. Okay, so my thoughts on the bookbinding guide. Let's start with the negatives. I think that the instructions that the booklet comes with aren't very clear. It has instructions for how to do a Coptic stitch and also the Japanese stamp binding, and they're really challenging to follow. So if you are using that booklet as a main resource to learn how to do these stitches, I wouldn't recommend it. It's kind of following the IKEA style of how to put stuff together with no words. And that doesn't work for my brain. So definitely go to YouTube to figure out how to learn those stitches if that's something that you want to do. Also, I thought the needles were a little too short and thin for my project, but that's a preference thing. If I was making a thinner book with thinner materials, then that probably wouldn't have been an issue. But positives, it definitely made punching the holes easier. I didn't have to fuss with a measuring stick. I didn't have to essentially make a guide like what I would do for my other projects. It's already there and measured out. So for convenience, A+. If you have to make a lot of books or you want to make a lot of books, this tool is definitely one that I would recommend to make the production easier and faster. So I think considering the price of this tool and how intuitive it is, I would definitely recommend it for beginner bookmakers, but it's not a necessity. Like, you can easily get a piece of chipboard or a thicker cardstock, do your measurements once on where you want your holes to be, and then lay it over top of your signatures or your cover to punch your holes. If you guys want to try this tool out, I'll make sure to link it in the description below. And if you end up making something with it, take a picture of it, send it to me. We're on Instagram at 1134press. If you want to connect with me there, that's where I am as well. So yeah, that's all I have to say. We will see you all in the next video. Thank you so much for watching. Bye.